Welcome, Jessica. It's so nice to meet you. We've sort of been trying to connect on LinkedIn. And I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about TransferWise. I'm fascinated about the business.
Yeah, sure. So TransferWise is an international money transfer platform. It's a FinTech company. We were founded in 2010, based in London, but we have investors like Andreessen Horowitz, Peter Thiel, et cetera, in the Bay Area, so still maintain the connection here. We have been very much focused on sort of innovating in this space. Previously, when you send money internationally with banks, it's incredibly expensive. And so for us, it's about making it a lot fairer, a lot cheaper, which ends up being a lot cheaper, and just more transparent. You get the exact exchange rate that you see on Google, all of that stuff where, you know, we really build the trust with the customer that we're doing the right thing on their behalf, and then we work really hard to bring that cost down and make it more convenient and do the right thing. In recent months, we've sort of expanded our scope now, so helping people manage their money, people and businesses actually manage their money internationally. So now we've launched this thing called the Borderless Account, where we'll give you, it's a virtual account where you'll have like a bank details in the Europe, in the UK, in the US, wherever you need a bank account. And so it's essentially like you can transact and do business and have local details in all the markets.
And how have the banks taken you this? Because I've lived in quite a few countries. I had a business in Ireland for 13 years, 2 years in London, over 7 years here, and I'm originally Australian. Oh my God, when I first left Australia and went to Ireland, the cost of transferring money was prohibitive. And just the fee that they took was absolutely prohibitive. I didn't know whether it was just the Irish banks, but it was pretty remarkable. And that was a real eye-opener. I obviously ended up doing a lot of transactions on PayPal, but that's not really satisfactory either if you're trying to get money to people or large amounts of money. So how have the banks received?
It's an interesting dynamic. So we work very closely with the banks, actually. We can't survive, actually, without banks. The way we operate is that we have a local bank account in each of the different markets. And then, so essentially, if you're, you know, transferring from Australia to Ireland, you pay into your local bank account from your local bank account in Australia to our local bank account in Australia. And then on the other side, we send from our Irish bank to your Irish bank. So this is the way that we sort of, you know, instead of sending the money individually every time, we sort of net it out, and that enables it to be a lot cheaper. So we can't do what we do without banks. That said, I think banks are taking a pretty hard look in terms of, you know, like we're growing and they're losing, you know, a big component of what used to make them a lot of money. And so I think it's a really good push from our side for them to think about, hey, what matters to the customer? How do we do the right thing for the customer? And I think they're starting to feel a little bit of that pressure.
So, like a lot of industries these days, the incumbents are being shaken up a little, and that's good for us, right? What's your personal vision of the future as regards the fintech startups and the banks?
Yeah, it's funny, like working in a fintech startup, you know, being in the industry, there's so much more room. So even within payments, which is where I'm working now, there's so much more space to get to before we can have fully instant payments, fully free payments, fully convenient, as easy as sending a text message. We're still pretty far from that. And that requires a lot of sort of like working together with the governments to figure out how to change that infrastructure. So for example, in the United States, there's still a lot of check writing going on. We're still using a lot of the ACH system. There's a lot of that stuff that needs to be fundamentally overhauled until we sort of can reach there. So I'm excited about that. There's still a long way to go. There's still a lot of challenges to work through. And then it's the same thing for each of the other fintech industries too. And many of them are even more nascent.
Thank you so much, and I'm so looking forward to this panel. Even though it's going to be a large one, I think we have some interesting discussion.
Great. Excited as well. Thank you.